We did not play good enough defensively. We didn't get off the field on third downs. We didn't convert on third downs. We kind of reverted back to some of the things we had done in the past defensively, things that we had to correct before, so we'll have to start trying to correct them again. And but I do, you know, I think the team is ready to play. We start out fast. We wanted to start out fast. We got up 10-0, and we didn't finish as good enough as we needed to. I don't think we ran the ball well enough. They were running some zone blitzes to stop the running game some. And the one long run that Jarek had was a zone blitz that we blocked very well. And then a couple others we missed a block here or there. And then we didn't play good enough to win. No, we practiced very well. None of that showed up in practice. They were enthusiastic, energetic before the game. They were like that. We started out the game. And just sometimes when we're not having the success that we expect to have, guys try to do a little bit too much sometimes, and I think that's what happened yesterday. The two first third downs of the ball game, we missed tackles, which we would have had them out. And so, you start getting frustrated. You change some of the things because of what's going on as a signal caller. You start doing other things, and like everybody else, I was frustrated as well. They're good backs too, and but one we overran it, the guy spun back on us, those kind of things. But if we make the tackle there, which we've been pretty good in those situations, make the tackle there, they're punting, and then everybody's feeling good about things. And so it just kind of steamrolled after that for a little bit.
Are there any mental mistakes or issues that you're seeing that prompt or tech in the last couple of weeks?
Mentally, he's actually pretty good. He's helping the receivers out where they're supposed to be and where they're supposed to go. There's times when the things I thought he did good yesterday, I thought especially in the second half, he moved in the pocket to allow things to develop down the field a little bit more, and I thought that helped early in the game. We're talking to him about getting the ball out fairly quick, and early in the game, he might have, there's a lot of times protection was good, and he probably could have waited a little bit longer until something else developed before getting rid of the ball. But it's kind of the feel as you go kind of thing. But we went down there in the first drive, I believe it was, and kicked a field goal. And so yeah, what do you want me to talk about? I think Cordero is a young developing player that has been in third offense in 3 years, hasn't been a receiver for a long time, so we're going to continue to be patient with him and keep teaching him and keep working with him and try and get him to where he needs to be in all those areas. So he does some very, very good things, and then some things that you don't like as much. So I don't think disappointed is the right word. I think youth might be the right word.
What do you think is the biggest thing holding him back right now?
Just youth. Just, the continually developing as a receiver, continually to understand all the complexities. He's just a young guy. And so, and with the third offense, second offense here, and he's at Tennessee for a short amount of time as a receiver. Sometimes it takes time with young guys, and I believe that's the case with him. I believe that he's going to be a really good player, but it's, everybody's impatient, including me, and I'm sure he is too, but it'll come. It took, Norv and I talk about these things a lot, and it takes some guys longer than others just because of the, we talk about some of the guys he's had as young players, and in the same, and he talks about other guys like that. So it just may take a while. Sorry.
This is a very young team. How, when the season starts to turn a little bit, how do you keep their attention, their focus, this late in the year?
Keep my thumb on.
Can you talk about the challenges of facing the Packers now, the way they're playing? I mean, Brian Robinson said, we're catching them at bad time, is what he said. Just the challenges of facing them, 108 points in those 2 games.
Yeah, well, they're good. They've got a lot of weapons. Defensively, they're playing well, too. I mean, they're doing a lot of good things. They got a lot of good players. Rodgers is, he's like one of those three-point shooters that you get in a roll and you hit him from anywhere. And that's kind of how he is right now, the way he's throwing the ball. He runs. He's got a great grasp of the offense, of telling guys where to go. The receivers are doing a great job of being in the right place. They go up and catch the ball. Lacy's a big, physical, strong back, and their offensive line is big and physical. And defensively, they're playing with a lot of confidence. They're using Peppers in a lot of good ways. Matthews, obviously, and I think they're playing good in the secondary.
Where do you think Rodgers ranks him on?
Oh, I don't know. I'm not going to rank him. He's good. He's really good.
How did Rudolph come out of the game yesterday? Was that pretty much the plan to use him, kind of ease him back in the way you guys did?
Yeah, he's feeling his way a little bit still, and so, he's got to let it loose a little bit more. We want to be careful with him, but on the same token, he needs to, continue to feel good about where he's at and kind of let it loose too.
I mean, some of those missed tackles with Anthony Barr, was it an alignment issue or was it just poor form of tackling?
Just missed tackles. It wasn't. He had a couple alignment errors yesterday, but the missed tackles were more about overrunning it or being in the wrong position, but it wasn't alignments.
Was Kyle holding himself back a little bit yesterday?
No, I don't think he was holding himself back, but I don't know that he had he was confident, but I don't know if he was really confident. You know what I mean? As far as, okay, I can go run this route as hard as I can run. Kyle's a great competitive kid that wants to please and do everything he can. And if there's a chance that he's going to try to play, he's going to play regardless of if he's 99% or he's 88%. So I think he needed to get back into it. He was a little bit rusty, in my opinion, but I think he just needs to get back into it more.
You mentioned
Well, a little bit. It wasn't so much about with Kyle, but we've been practicing that 2-minute drill with Chase in there quite a bit.
You mentioned the lack of running game at the outset here. Was that due to Jarek's back at all, or just?
No, they were.
You were still in the game.
Yeah. No, it wasn't. It wasn't so much that. They were making a conscious effort of run blitzing in the gaps, and if you hit them right, you're gonna stop some things. And so when you do that, it opens up some other areas, and we try to hit some other areas.
Talk about reaching the head to get the ball out pretty quick. Do you think that caused him to not look downfield as much yesterday?
No, I don't think it caused him to do that. I think it was, we're always stressing to get the ball out quick, so it wasn't that. But he probably could have been a little bit more patient at times. But the thing I liked that he did, what I thought he did as good as anything was, you know, there was a couple plays where he stepped up in the pocket and, you know, let the rush get past and then step up and found some guys down the field. And, that, you know, I thought that was good.
What adjustments could you have made? You kind of talked a little bit about MVP with Josh to maybe make him less vulnerable.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to talk about what things I could have done, but I could have done something. I'm not going to tell you, I guess, is what I'm saying, because I don't want to tell the world.
Are there any injuries that you have any concern about, Wright or Jennings or anybody?
No, I mean, they seem to be okay. We'll have to find out how they are during the week.
Were you guys one of the teams that the DEA checked out yesterday? I know that there was a Washington Post report that the DEA was checking out teams to check for restricted drugs.
I did not see that report. I did hear about it. I'm not going to talk about if we were or we weren't, but we're in good shape here. I did talk to the league today about it, and they said there's a lot of things they need to look into and have protocol for in case a situation like that arises, and things they'll discuss. And No, the clock, the only time the clock was an issue really was in the last 2 minutes. The Bears beat us, okay? It wasn't the clocks. The Bears beat us. They performed better than we did. At the end of the day, at the 2 minute drill, the clock became an issue because of not knowing how much time was left on the clock. And Teddy thought at that point when he threw the interception, he thought the clock was down and he tried to make a play in the end zone. That's really the only time, and it being a little disconcerting for the offense in the 2 minute drill was the biggest issue. Now, the Bears had the same thing. They could have had different changes, different, you know, if they know it's a minute left in the game and or 10 seconds left, they're going to make different calls as well. So I'm not going to put it all on that, but it is a you know, you've got a young quarterback running a 2 minute drill and can't find anywhere in the place where there's how much time is left, and so that is a little bit disconcerting. But we didn't deserve to win the game, regardless if we would have tied it up.